Welcome here to the Queen's Home in Hexham for our 27th Panto. Tonight's performance is Sleeping Beauty. We have a large cast backstage made up of costume farmers members from the last few years, some that's been a bit longer since they were in Young Farmers. And they put a lot of effort and time together in practicing for tonight's performance. They've spent since August practicing most weeks, the three times a week. Right, I'm going to now hand over to our cast, and I hope you all enjoy the performance this evening. Thank you very much.
Oh, what a beautiful day.
nice place to live. Steady mind, I said nice, not rice. The king didn't like anyone making jokes about ambrosia. And if anyone does, the palace guards take them into custody. Only joking. As I was saying, it's a lovely place to live. Especially now since the last dragon was slain. Oh, that's right. We used to have a real fire-breathing dragon here in the village. And the king offered a huge reward to anyone who would get rid of it. Now let me see. First, there was the Pied Piper, who became the Fried Piper. Then the knight called Rab, he became a kebab. Then there was a bit of a lobby, until a knight from Camelot came, speared the dragon, made it roll over, and hit the jackpot. So now there's nothing to be scared of. All night long. Except that's not quite true, because there's still Dame Time. And believe me, she is much scarier than any dragon. And talk about taste. Well, she's the only person I know who was asked to leave a library because her clothes were too loud. And fancy. Count her boy Justin. Oh, I'll tell ya.
Hear ye, hear ye! Their Royal Majesty is hereby invite all citizens of Ambrosia to a fancy dress ball tomorrow at the palace to celebrate the 18th birthday of the Princess Nightingale! Hear ye, hear ye!
Hey, you! It's Waller! The idiot! But he never goes anywhere without that box of his. In fact, we all like to play a little game round here called What's in the Box, Walter? And you can all join in. Whenever anybody asks, what's in the box, Walter, you join in too. Shall we try it?
Yes.
Right then. After three. Three!
What's in the box, Walter?
Four candles.
You'd never fit four candles in that little box, Walter. Simple
yourself.
They'll never know what's coming. Here, Walker. Have you heard of it before? It'll be even bigger than the one that had for Professor Newton when he won the Nobel Prize.
Professor Newton won a prize for not having a bell.
No, Walker. It was the Alfred Nobel Prize.
It's Alfred won one as well. Hey, can I have one?
What for?
I haven't got a bell either.
Got all you haven't got. Bye, Walker. Justin, have you heard the news?
No, what news?
The King and Queen have thrown a fancy dress ball at the palace for Princess Nightingale's 18th birthday party, and the whole kingdom has been invited.
Oh, no.
What's the matter? I thought it liked a good do.
Yeah, and so does Mother. Remember the last time she went to a party?
How can I forget? She thought a pajama party meant you had to turn up in whatever you slept in. She only slept in a birthday suit.
It was so embarrassing.
Not as embarrassed as her outfit. Oh, she's not with you, is she?
Nah, she's seeing to her roots.
Dye the hair again, I tell you. Your mother changes colour more often than a set of tap plates.
No, it's beach roots.
That'd be true, I tell you.
No, she's seeing to her beach roots. It's the only crop we've got left. And we're so good, she's asked me to pawn her wedding ring.
So you really aren't going to party then?
Wild horses couldn't drag me there. Besides, Princess Nightingale wouldn't be interested in commoners like us now, would she?
Come, speak for yourself.
Anyway, I'd best be going. See you later, Felix.
See you, Justin. And I'd better be off too, before that Dame Time turns up. Oh, she fancies me like mad. I'd have to be mad to fancy her. Now, I wouldn't say she was ugly, but she must have sucked an apple or lemon to look the way she does. And you know, she's always knitting me presents. So far, she's knitted me three pairs of socks, none of which match, two scarves along the football pitch, and five jumpers that feel as though the sheep are still inside them. I suppose her heart's in the right place. Unfortunately, it's the only part of her that is.
Just...
Uh-oh. Where is that boy?
I sent him to the village hours ago.
Oh,
you never had a tally that in Blackpool?
Oh, yes, I did. Well,
to Blackpool. Oh, I love Blackpool, don't you?
Yes.
Sandy floss, bingo, fish and chips, and that was only on the coach going. I even went in the big one, you know, the Coca-Cola.
But you mean the Pepsi Max?
Coca-Cola, Pepsi, what's the difference? Have any of you not been on it?
Yes.
Were you frightened?
Yes.
Well, I wasn't. It takes a lot to frighten me.
That's because she's the one doing all the frightening.
I beg your pardon.
So did anybody get frightened?
Well, there was one young man sat sitting on his own who looked rather nervous. And as I moved closer and closer, I could see him getting more and more frightened.
Don't blame him.
So I sat next to him and grabbed his hand tight and said, "Calm down, love. We haven't even started yet." But he just jumped off and screamed, "No! And I'm not going to either." I suppose the thought of going all the way was just too much for him.
You know exactly how it feels.
Don't you like scary rides, then?
Well, it all depends who sat next to me.
Oh, you'd be all right with me holding your hand.
No, that's scary. Yeah, I just can't get Justin for you.
He'll keep. So, who are you taking to the Royal Ball, lover boy?
You know about the ball?
Yes, you are going, aren't you?
No, I'll give it a miss.
I'm still getting over the last pyjama party.
But that was years ago.
Was it? I suppose the nightmares will stop eventually. No, I'm going to have a quiet in instead.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good idea. You can light the candles and I'll bring a nice bottle of beetroot wine.
Beetroot wine?
Yes, I've got gallons of the stuff. Get that down you, it'll put hairs on your chest. Not that you need any more.
Are you sure it's safe to drink?
Yes, just keep it away from plastics, upholstery and polished surfaces.
On second thought, maybe you should go. After all, it is a royal invite. So, what are you thinking of wearing, Mike?
Well, I was thinking of going dressed as a giant spoon.
That just caused quite a stir.
And what about you?
Oh, I was going to go as Invisible Man. With a bit of luck, she won't see me.
What did you say?
I said I hope the drinks are free.
Oh, you're coming then.
They do say there's safety in numbers.
That's what you think.
Whoa, back up, Susan boy.
Give us a kiss.
Ready?
Hey, Felix. What are you waiting for? Come back here, what tease?
Carrying it.
Don't you know what a plan is?
Of course I do. tomorrow myself.
I said planned, not planned.
How would I get lumbered with you?
Way, we've got the same van.
Yes, and that's the only reason I put up with you.
If our man would see the way you treat me, she'd torn in her grave.
Mum's not dead.
Isn't she?
No, she's alive and well, works in Iceland.
I didn't know she'd emigrated.
She works in frozen foods, you idiot.
Well, it is cold over there.
If you raise with dynamite, you would never know. You'll blow your own nose.
That's not funny.
That's a cunning, wicked, and evil plan!
I know! But you won't get paid extra for flattery.
You can rely on us, Mrs.
Miss! Oh,
there's that beekeeper!
Oh, fool! There is no bee in here!
Oh,
ox or tin and hide it under the bed.
Why?
Well, because that's what man used to do.
Only to stop the landlord getting his hands on it. Oh. Mind you, that's not the only thing he tried getting his hands on.
That's true. Maybe that's why Mum emigrated.
Mum hasn't emigrated. But maybe you should.
Why?
To prevent me from throttling you. Now we are ready.
Zendora will fill with fear. The Princess Nightingale will have to beware, but I will be near to lend a
Well, that's the last of the beetroot dug up. And once these have gone, we'll have nothing left to eat. Aww. Where's that?
Well, the pay
hadn't dried, so he charged me 50 pence for the white spirit to get the paint off his hands.
White spirit? I'll give him white spirit. He'll be a white spirit by the time I finish with him.
Never mind all that. Have you heard about the royal ball?
Oh, yes. Felix practically begged me to go with him. I wonder if he'll wear that jumper I knitted him for his birthday.
You can't expect him to wear that thing. It's got one sleeve longer than the other.
Can I help it if I run out of wool?
I don't know why you bother. You know you're a hopeless knitter.
Rubbish! Everyone says I'm a great knitter.
No, it just sounds like they're saying you're a great knitter.
Oh, what do you know?
Anyway, I'd best be off. Please, some potatoes from the market. See you later!
Aren't you going to help me with these beetroots? Oh, kids! Wasn't I that mighty?
Certainly, Your Majesty,
suddenly.
Winning
it. You must stay
pretend or expect to find the princess in the palace?
Yes, she probably will. Mm. But at least that way we can protect her. Mm. Go! She'll never get past our palace guards.
She got past them once before, Your Highness. I think the princess would be safer in the village than the palace.
Nonsense! She'd stay out of my house.
Oh, no, not if I dressed her like a villager.
And not having my daughter wearing red.
But, Father, the villagers don't wear rags these days.
They don't?
No, sir. I mean, the high street is full of designer fashion shops. I mean, I got this lovely little outfit from Buttons and Bows.
How did he get in here?
Oh, I haven't a clue, sir.
So what's new? Well, go and ask him then.
Yes, sir. Walter, how did you get into the palace? He doesn't know, Your Majesty.
But I thought everybody knew me.
No, Your Majesty, he knows you, Your Majesty, but he doesn't know how you got in the palace, Your Majesty.
Is he an idiot?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Are you taking the royal mitt again?
No, Your Majesty. Walter is the official village idiot.
I see. Well, ask him what's in the box then.
Yes, yes.
What's in the box, Walter?
Chips for my computer.
He's not that stupid if he knows about computers. Are they memory chips, Walter?
No, not dirty chips.
Computer chips, Walter.
Mine does, he loves them.
He?
With her mouth? I call him computer on account of him being so clever.
Compared to you, he's probably a genius.
Well, best get up before these chips get cold, eh?
What a strange person. Mm. At least he can come and go as he pleases, unlike me.
Thank you. may go to the village after all.
Can I?
But please promise me you'll look after yourself and be careful.
I promise I will, darling. Okay, I'd better go and get ready.
Free for me, Your Highness, I don't trust the outfit. If anything happens to her, I'll never forgive myself.
Well, at least there aren't any dragons left to worry about.
That reminds me, Bee. What time's your mother appearing tomorrow?
Mother warned me against marrying you. She always said I'd marry someone with a trade.
I begin.
That's all very well, dear. But what could you turn your hand to if you lost your crown?
But I'm not going to lose my crown.
King Rudolph of Lapland lost his crown. And look what happened to him.
What happened to him?
He didn't reign, dear. Rudolph didn't reign, dear.
Enough of this silliness, Bee. Come along. Let's go and see what that fool of a valet is dressing our daughter in. Like silks and pearls from buttons and bows.
The fools think they can avoid their fate, but they'll not escape Zendora's hate. My evil plan is a thing of beauty when sage and onion do their duty. So, when all the kingdom the party attend, their cozy world will come to an end. Oh, my revenge complete, no matters pending. They can say goodbye to their happy ending.
Away, O evil one, depart. You shall not gladden your twisted heart. The Princess Nightingale will sing once more, though you think her dead upon the floor. Her true love's kiss will give her life, and she will consent to be his wife. Your wicked spell he will undo. So be gone, Zendora. Shoo, shoo, shoo.
Shut your mouth, you stupid fairy. You sound like a milkmaid from Wheelbert's Dairy. Now, I will hold my anger back. But one day soon you'll cop your whack.
Zendora thinks she's mighty tough, but I am made of sterner stuff. She doesn't scare me one little bit. I'll kick her butt so hard, she'll struggle to sit. What is this feeling so sudden and new?
I felt the moment I laid eyes on you.
My pulse is rushing.
My head is reeling.
My face is flushing. What is this feeling? Burning as a flame. Does it have a name? Loathing! Unadulterated loathing. For your face,
your voice,
your clothing. Let's just say, I love it all. Every little trace.
maids. It was while I was working there that my husband ran off for that barmaid. And 9 months later, Justin was born. Now I know what you're all thinking. Is he or isn't he? Well, you can just carry on guessing. Let's just say I wasn't a very fast runner. Justin does look rather regal, don't you think? Well, look at this one puzzling away like a kid in a sweet shop. How much more of a clue do you need, love? Look. Do you like the dress?
Yes.
I call it my stock exchange dress. I've invested everything in it, and I'm hoping for a big return. Speaking of returns, and where do you think you're going?
Nowhere.
Correct in one. I make a word in your ear, lover boy.
I just can't fix the earplugs.
Give over. I only want to whisper sweet nothings.
That's what I'm afraid of.
What would you do if I was the only...
Join a monastery.
Oh, I like a man with a sense of humour. What do you think of my new dress, Felix?
That thing wouldn't even attract flies.
What?
I said it brings out the colour of your eyes.
I got it from that shop what sells clothes once more by the stars of the stage and screen. Oh, what's it called?
Little Shop of Lovers?
Chick! This stuff is all the rage.
That dress could put anyone in a rage.
This dress was once worn by one of the Spice Girls. Can you guess which one?
Old Spice?
No! Jerry Halliwell!
And now it's been worn by Geriatric!
Oh, you are awful! But I like you! So what time are you picking me up then?
I think it's me that needs picking up.
You walk with your Felix!
Actually, I was thinking it'd be more fun if we go separately.
But how will I recognise you?
Well, I'll be dressed as a gorilla.
Oh, it'll be like Beauty and the Beast!
I'll let you decide which is which.
What did you say?
I said I hope the outfit doesn't make me itch.
Ah, well, if it does, I'll scratch it for you.
I just can't get the costume.
How's about a little kiss before you go?
I would love to, but I've got a terrible cold and achoo! And I've got to get to a chemist pretty sharp.
A little cold shouldn't bother a big, strong man like you.
I'll have you know, I was once a weak man.
Well, once a week's enough for any man. Besides which, I've got everything you need right here in my handbag.
Let's have a look. Andrex. Carex. Optrex, Pyrex, Turex!
Duracell batteries!
How was it with the escape?
You'll be in more than luck to escape me!
Pretend there's an echo in here in order to make money out of it.
people. It's simple.
Simple? You're the one that's simple. How are we going to make money by pretending there's an echo in here?
I'll show you. Now stand over there, out of sight, and repeat everything I say.
Well, I'll just repeat everything you say.
Yes, now get out of sight. Can you hear me?
Why, of course I can.
Stay out of sight and repeat everything I say.
Oh, I've got it.
Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
How are you?
Wait, as you can see, I'm having a bit of bother with me back.
No. Just stay out of sight and repeat everything I say.
I've got it now.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
How are you?
My dog has fleas.
Well, you want to get yourself a sandwich? Put some mouse powder on it.
Will you do as I say? Someone's coming. Quick, get out of sight. Remember what I said.
Okay. I'll be brilliant this day.
That'll make a change.
Hello. How are you?
Very well, thanks. I'm a bit worried about this echo here.
What echo? Where?
This echo here.
There's no echo in here.
Oh, yes, there is.
Rubbish. I used to do my courting in here, and if there was an echo, I would have had twice the fun.
I'll bet you £10. There's an echo here.
You're wrong. Come on, then. Prove it.
Right. Listen to this. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
How are you?
Oompa, oompa.
Stupid oompa.
Shh. certainly, sir. It's just in time.
That's right. How did you know?
Because we close in 5 minutes.
Oh, I see. Just in time?
That's what I said.
Thanks.
Here you go, then.
Thank you.
town hall.
I thought everyone knew that.
I'm good, can't ask everyone.
Should have seen that one coming.
Hang on a minute, Felix. I think we've forgotten something.
What's in the box, Walter?
Nuts.
Oh, I only asked.
Chestnuts.
Oh, can I have some? I love chestnuts. Walter, what are these? I thought you said they were chestnuts.
No. The nuts of the old chest of drawers.
Thanks, but I'm not that hungry.
Suit yourself, more for me.
You don't think he's good?
Nah.
Not even he's that stupid. Is he?
Hey, where the girls gone?
Oh, they must have left while we were talking to Walter. Did anybody see which way they went?
Cheers, one person did.
Like to buy some of the sweetest beetroot in the kingdom.
Well, I don't buy if I just sell it.
Yes, but you have to buy it first in order to sell it.
So you want me to buy your veg so I can sell it back to you?
Yes. I mean, no. You buy it from me and sell it to somebody else.
Well, it just cut out middleman.
Don't tell to me.
You remind me of somebody who were here earlier.
Well, I have heard that Beyonce sometimes shops in the village.
You know, it was some young farmer.
Do I look like a young farmer?
Say you look like him.
I should think not. No,
too. No. He was quite good looking, really.
Just what are you insinuating?
He were daft and all.
Chick! I should take my beetroot elsewhere.
Hey, compost heaps that way.
That's funny. I thought I was standing next to it.
It's no use. They've gone.
Oh, what look? I'm sure that Cynthia fancied me, you know.
Yeah, well, she was doing a pretty good job of hiding it. Probably never see either of them again now.
The fancy dress ball?
Of course! But Felix in his fancy dress, and how would we recognise them?
Oh, I'll have no trouble recognising my Cynthia.
How come?
She'd be dressed as Nell Gwynn.
Who's Nell Gwynn?
No idea. But apparently she always carries a big basket of oranges.
Large chaffers.
Can't say enough.
Never mind. Come on, look.